Okay, a few months back, I picked up this issue of Surfer Magazine, and my mind was blown by this picture showing Kelly Slater surfing a sci-fi at Cloudbreak, shot by Todd Glasser. I hung it on the wall behind me because I liked it so much, and I'm not the only person who was mesmerized by this photograph.
Just a super interesting image for a surfboard designer to study. I guess it's just like how cleanly the water's releasing off the tail and how you can actually see the channels creating a track. It's definitely showing you what the board is doing, you know. It's a really good peak moment of a you know, high speed maneuver, and you can just see that everything's functioning the way it's supposed to be functioning. So that's, you know, good to see as a designer that your stuff's performing as it's supposed to.
You see, what makes a picture like this so captivating is what you can learn by looking at it very closely. But you're still limited because you can't extract data out of a photograph. And this is one of the reasons that technology is becoming increasingly important for everyone in the surfboard industry.
There's no question shaping is an art form, but the refinement of shape has required the marriage of art and technology. And I think if you look at the influence of Shape3D and AccuShaper and those various CAD programs, they've definitely elevated the refinement of the modern surfboard. So building on that foundation of art and technology, CFD, or computational fluid dynamics, seems to be the logical next step in that further evolution of the modern surfboard.
So what is CFD? Well, if you look at some of the world's most famous sports car brands, like Pagani, you'll see that they use computational fluid dynamics software to help design the most aerodynamic sports cars possible. So when a scientist from Italy named Riccardo Rossi approached us at Firewire, we said yes to his offer to run some of our surfboard models through his computational fluid dynamics software. Because Riccardo is not just a surfer, he is also well known in Italian sports car circles. You're about to join us for a conversation that is not about proving one surfboard is better than the other, but if you do want an uncommonly deep look at how surfboards work, I think you'll really enjoy this video. Now, the first thing that I asked Riccardo to explain to us was this pressure distribution that he created for the sci-fi, because it mimics that image of Kelly surfing a sci-fi at Cloudbreak.
So what do you see when you look at this? Can you walk us through what the colors mean and possibly what the water flow means when you look at this?
Sure. You can kind of recognize a bunch of different features. Perhaps the high pressure here near the impact of the water with the board. And also you can notice how the pressure is changing from the higher pressure back to atmospheric pressure out the tail. Mm-hmm. And so you have this gradient of pressure in between, which is really connected to the rocker curve of the board. At the same time, you can see probably this low pressure region near the rail, and this is more connected to the rail flow and the rail shape, which is of course a big deal. Uh-huh. And also the pressure in the back, again, kind of influenced by the tail shape and the presence of the channels in the sci-fi.
One of the easiest things for me to grasp,
yeah,
given that I came into this with no knowledge of CFD at all,
mm-hmm,
was the work that you did with rails.
Right.
So can you walk us through what you're seeing when you look at a softer rail versus a harder rail with a harder edge down here on the bottom versus a more rounded edge? It's also interesting to see that this board here has a deeper concave coming, yep, to a harder edge, mm-hmm, and this has less of a concave coming to a softer bottom edge.
Right.
What are you seeing in the pressure distributions represented by these colors?
So here we have two different boards. This one here on the left is actually the Omni by Slater Designs, and this one here is actually from an Italian company, a brand that is emerging now in the Italian market. It's called Sequoia,
mm-hmm,
and I'll be also working with these guys. And so you can see that, like you said, the shape is different. So we have a harder rail here, and we have a softer rail here, and also a deeper concave in the board from Sequoia. So what's happening here is the water flow can really get around the rail, so that the smoother design of the rail in this case allows the flow to really wrap around it and accelerate. And you know, when the speed goes up, the pressure goes down. And so you have a suction strong suction going on here around this rail, which is not happening here because the water, because of the concave and also because of this harder rail, can really go or can really stand the pressure gradient here. And mm-hmm. so the water just, you know, keeps going, kind of releases from the rail. And so you don't have the same accelerated flow. And because of that, you don't have the same suction that you have on this board here. Mm.
So what you're seeing is just a real visual representation of water wanting to wrap around rounder surfaces yeah. and shear off yeah. of hard surfaces?
That's correct. And this is also another picture that I really like because, you know, there's always been a lot of talking in the community about the rail designs. You know, there are people or shapers that like more the softer, you know, rail design. Other guys prefer maybe the harder rail. So I'm not saying here that this board is better than this one or the other way around. It's more that with CFD now we can have a more better understanding, a deeper understanding of what's going on the board. So maybe if you want to have a kind of more like a loose feeling, you would maybe prefer a little bit the harder rail. If you want to feel the board more engaged with the face of the wave, maybe because you're just going down straight down the line in a big barrel, maybe you would like to have something like a softer rail.
Something I've always been fascinated by when it comes to surfboard design is yeah. the idea that you can make small changes to a surfboard mm-hmm. that have very big impacts
yeah.
to how the board feels while you're surfing it.
Yeah.
And you kind of looked at that idea in relation to rocker. Can you walk us through this image and what you're seeing with the color distribution and what you found as far as slight or moderate or big changes to rocker?
Right. So here we were playing around with the rocker cure, especially in the tail. So this is a comparison between two designs for a kind of a standard shoreboard. That one on top is the baseline model. And the one below would be the one with less rocker in the tail. Mm-hmm. And so you see how the pressure is changing, and not just near the tail, because perhaps you would expect that the biggest change in the design is right here. And so you would think that the pressure would change right on this spot and, you know, wouldn't do much forward or upwind, you know, this spot here. But what's really happening is the water flow is slowing down because of the less tail rocker. Mm-hmm. And so this pressure is rising all over the place, also in the middle of the board. And if you look carefully, you can even see the impact line, which is moving upwards, right?
Impact line meaning where, like, if water's flowing this way, the water's impacting the board now earlier?
Exactly. Even though the design and the nose is not changing. So the rocker is changing from pretty much the center of the board towards the tail, okay? Mm-hmm. And so it's a kind of, you know, was a little bit surprising, you know, for me coming from experiences with, you know, motorsports applications like cars and motorbikes. When you make a change, it's a big change, right? So you would expect that the drag and lift forces would change a lot.
Mm-hmm.
But with boards, you know, the changes can be really subtle. And so in this case, I think we put probably half an inch less in the tail rocker, and the dynamic lift would change by 50%.
So 50% change in dynamic lift throughout yeah. the board.
Excellent.
From just how much of a change to the tail rocker?
Half an inch.
So one of the most fun things to look at that you did is an animation that shows half of an Omni and half of a sci-fi. It's like you made one board and one half is an Omni and the other half is a sci-fi.
Right.
And you illustrated how those two different outlines move through the water. Can you walk me through what you're seeing
yeah.
when you compare the outline of the sci-fi and an Omni?
So that's really one of the other benefits, you know, from using CFD, because you really get a comprehensive picture of the whole flow field. So you're not gonna get just, you know, pressure and velocity. You're also gonna get other information like turbulence. And turbulence, of course, is really important when it comes, you know, to drag, because, you know, the higher the turbulence around the board, the higher the drag, you know, mm-hmm. you would find in your board while you're riding it. And so here we're looking at the free surface. So you can probably recognize the water being released by the outline here.
Mm-hmm.
So with it would impact around here the board and then kind of flowing at the bottom, but also moving sideways, right? And so we have the wake here and also the wake in the after the tail of the board.
The most interesting thing to me is it looks like it's wrapping more. You like sort of see the wake wrapping around the Omni more, where it shears off the sci-fi more.
Exactly. And so this is kind of interesting because it would be it's probably a bit counterintuitive that you know, the turbulence is actually higher for the Omni than for the sci-fi. And the reason why it could be a little bit counterintuitive is the design of the sci-fi, at least in the tail, is really complex, right? So we have the double bed, we have the channels, and so you would think that because of the more sharpie kind of outline that you have in the back, there would be more, you know, turbulence in the flow. Mm-hmm. But it's actually the other way around. So the Omni, because of, you know, the flow being able to wrap around the outline, there is more like a velocity component in the third direction, and that gives you more like shear and more turbulence. So you can really see here by the contour, which is showing you that turbulence intensity from low blue to high red.
For a lot of us when we're surfing, you know, you're a scientist. For a lot of us, we don't necessarily think about turbulence that often.
Right.
What is turbulence, and what are you inferring about the way that a surfboard might feel while you're surfing it based on, for example, a sci-fi emitting less turbulent flow and an Omni emitting more turbulent flow?
Yeah. Well, so the direct consequence would be to experience less drag, and that's actually what's happening with the sci-fi, because the sci-fi has for sure less drag than the Omni, that has, you know, other characteristics, other, you know, performances as a board. But the sci-fi for sure, especially here, if you look at the turbulence level in the outer tail, you have a bit more of a turbulence here because the flow is really fast. It's coming out the channel with a very high speed. Mm-hmm. And so that really gives you a lot of drive and a lot of speed when you're surfing the sci-fi. So that would be for sure a direct consequence.
So the reason that, like, looking at this animation illustrating water turbulence is important is if you see less turbulence, that means less drag, which would generally imply more speed. But you found some really interesting stuff when you compared a sci-fi, a Vader, and an Omni.
Yeah.
They performed very differently depending on what speed each board was traveling through the water at.
Yeah.
Can you walk us through that?
Here we're looking at planing, simple planing, let's say. Mm-hmm. And we are looking at the shear forces, so the friction between the water and the surface of the board, right? Uh-huh. And so you can probably notice the kind of the footprint of the channels that are in the sci-fi, kind of reducing the shear that you have with the water. And so this really goes back to what we were talking about before, being the sci-fi really a fast board.
Is the green inferring like minimal drag?
Yeah, lower friction, for
okay,
sure.
Lower friction.
Lower friction, yeah. And this is also something that depends on the speed of the board, because this kind of footprint would be a little bit less vivid if the speed would be lower, right?
Am I right that you found that a Vader, for example, has very minimal drag at low speeds, but once it starts going at very high speeds, it has more drag than an Omni? But an Omni at high speeds has minimal drag, but then at lower speeds it has more drag?
Yeah, so that's one of the things that was interesting to look at, because we actually performed two simulations for the Vader and the Omni at different speeds. And so we kind of found out that the Vader would be more efficient at lower speed than the Omni. And when I'm talking about efficiency, I'm talking about, if you like, a ratio between lift, which is something you would like to have, and drag, which is something that you don't want to have, at least not too much, right? Mm-hmm. You want some because you want to have control in your board, but not too much because you want to go fast on your on the wave. And so the case was a lower speed, the Vader would have a bit more lift and less drag than the Omni, and then when we increased the speed, it was the other way around. So again, it really comes down to having a better knowledge of what are the performances for the different conditions, because we're not really looking at finding the best board in the world, because I really think there is no, you know, best board overall, right? Mm-hmm. You just want to pick up the best board for your skills and also for the conditions, you know, you're gonna go surfing, I think.
Okay, we'll pause this conversation for now, but if you want more of our work with CFD, Ricardo Rossi, and a lot of other backstage stuff having to do with Slater Designs, Tomo Surfboards, and much more, you can join The Wire. The Wire is our backstage entrance to all things Firewire, and you can join by clicking the link down beneath this video. We'll see you soon on The Wire. Ow. Ow. Ow.